Hi, I'm Sam Lipsey, Agronomic Services Manager for Eastern Canada. And today I'm going to speak to you all about crop staging in cereals. Crop staging is becoming a more important attribute for a good agronomy in cereals, as we've seen the introduction of new plant growth regulators, such as Moddus. Moddus, the plant growth regulator, interacts with the cereal, particularly at growth stage 30 to 32, where we're looking to basically induce a stronger base. By doing so, we're able to increase other agronomic inputs around fertility, around sowing rates, around fungicides, etc., to actually grow a stronger crop. And Moddus creates that strong foundation that's required in order to do that. The area of focus today for crop staging is looking at what we call the growth stage 30s. Now, growth stage 30s is signified by that stem elongation, and that's when we start to see the nodes developing on the stems, and we're starting to see the internodal elongation between the nodes. Now, when looking at PGRs such as Moddus, this is a critical time for getting that product on in order to create a stronger foundation for a good, strong cereal crop when looking at inducing high yield expectations. So, at this particular crop that we're in now is probably around GS32. And now what I'm going to show you all is just how we go about actually selecting some plants and identifying those growth stages. When looking to assess a cereal field for crop staging, it's a good idea just to stand back and assess the overall condition of the field. Determine how even the field is. Look for areas that are a good representation of the field and then proceed to pull plants from those areas. You probably want to take half a dozen plants, and then with those plants, look to focus on the main stems. Remove the daughter tillers carefully, protecting that main stem, because that is what we're effectively going to assess. So once we have the individual stem, now's the time to actually use a nice small X-acto knife, something like what I have in my hand here. It needs to be nice and sharp. You need to be very careful because of that. And you don't want a knife that's too big, because that becomes cumbersome. And what we're actually going to look to do is slice longitudinally up that stem to expose those nodes inside. So what we usually do is we look to cut off just the very bottom, because that helps with the cutting of the stem. And then just very carefully, just move the knife up the middle of the stem. And you want to just, and when you get to the individual nodes, they will take a little bit more effort to push through. So you just want to be very careful that you don't slip with the knife. And once we get up towards the top of the plant, you can just pull it right the way through. And what we're going to end up with is two equals of that stem, of now we can make our assessment from. So here we have two stems which have been dissected up the centre. The one at the bottom of the screen is indicating a growth stage closer to GS30, just moving into 31. And that's signified by the position of the number of nodes, which we have one developing right at the base, which could be difficult to see. We also have just here the developing ear. And so how we signify GS30 is this first node is less than a centimetre above the ground. And the ear is more than a centimetre above the ground. This top stem that we have dissected is actually closer to GS32. And what signifies that is this first internode that we have here. Then we have more than 2 centimetres to the second internode. And then what we have here is the developing ear. So this particular stem that we have at the top is GS31 moving into GS32. So this, for me, is the perfect time to be applying our PGR in Moddus. So there you have it, a crash course on crop staging in cereals. It's not something that's too difficult, but it is something that does take a bit of time to learn. So I encourage you to get out there and get into those crops and get understanding. Enjoy the season and the best of luck. Thanks.